The government has set November this year as the month to start compulsory registration and issuance of DICTO number plates, starting with motorcycles. According to Minister of Works and Transport General Katumba Wamala, as well as the Minister of Security, retired Major General Jim Muhwezi, alongside the Chief Licensing Officer, Winston Katushabe, this process is long overdue because it was supposed to commence in March this year.
The rollout of the project was supposed to be on the 1st of March 2024, but it was postponed due to logistical challenges.
Removal, it must be a guided operation. Not every Tom, Dick and Harry can just remove the plates.
They said to date, they have registered over 1,000 vehicles, most of which are government-owned, as well as other organizations. The officials say after registering motorcycles in November this year, all vehicles shall then be made to register in January on a compulsory basis.
First registration is 714,300. The exchange of old number plates, like for example, Sigoa, if you have your vehicle right now, we shall charge you 150 to replace your registration plate.
It's the number plate. They have a tracker, they have a SIM chip, and the two Bluetooth beacons for both front and back.
Registration fee for vehicles already operating has been set at 170,000 shillings and 360,000 shillings for new cars respectively. According to the ministers, registration of vehicles and motorcycles will aid in tracking them in case of involvement in crime. The National Social Security Fund, NSSF, has earned 39.8 billion in dividends for the year that ended December 31, 2023, making it a total of 80.6 billion from its investment in MTN Uganda over the last 3 years. The payment is the largest the fund has earned from a listed company in the region this year, NSSF Managing Director Patrick Ayota told journalists today. Ayota boasted of the good performance of the fund, terming it a fully funded parastato as a result of accumulated assets.
The implication is right now the fund is what we call fully funded. Fully funded means that all the claims a member can have against the fund, what you've put in, what the employer has put in, what NSF has put in as interest, is fully covered by the assets of the fund. And if for some reason we close the fund today, we believe that within 1 year, would be able to pay off for every fund, because the real estate and equity may take us a bit of time to liquidate. And that's how healthy this fund is. Most pension funds are struggling with that aspect of what's called.
While handing over a dummy check to Patrick Ayota, NSSF Managing Director, for the year that ended December 2023, Slivia Mulinge, the MTN Uganda Chief Executive Officer, expressed gratitude to the NSSF for increasing their investment, and she urged Ugandans to continue their investing as MTN broadens its local shareholding participation.
So for us, our commitment remains as MTN to continue to expand and broaden the participation of local shareholders. And that is something that is a mandate that we've embraced at MTN group level. The offers and even just our listing on the stock exchange is an opportunity to all Ugandan retail and professional investors, including MTN Ugandan loyal customers, to continue to own a stake in this company, because MTN Uganda is your company.
The total dividend paid out of the financial year 2023 signals a 13.2% increase in payments to MTN shareholders from the previous year. U.S. Mission Uganda was closed today as officials at the embassy joined in celebrating America's Independence Day. The celebrations were joined by a Ugandan delegation led by the Minister of State for Foreign Affairs in charge of international cooperation, Okello Oryem. During the 248th Independence Day celebration of the United States of America, the United States Ambassador to Uganda, William Pope, emphasized the strong partnership between the American and Ugandan people for over 61.
And we are honored to be celebrating with many Ugandans from so many different backgrounds.
He thanked President Museveni for strengthening this cooperation and emphasized United States' commitment to fighting corruption and ensuring human rights prevail in Uganda.
Doing for more than 60 years here in Uganda and around the continent, programs that have lifted millions of people out of poverty, have helped hundreds of thousands of babies be born HIV free, have fought outbreaks of disease.
July 4th is the day when, in 1776, the Second Continental Congress adopted the Declaration of Independence, eventually transforming 13 colonies into the United States of America.